Hey guys, it's me, Purple Dinosaur. This is my first video, so, hope you like it. So, today, I'll teach you how to make an Undertale fan battle game on scratch. So, yeah. So, let's begin. And yes, we need to make a new project for this.
I
already have one, you don't need to. Okay guys, so once you're adding a project, like, start making the character that you, a character that will like, do the attacks and stuff. So put your character, so make the character that will like do the attacks and stuff. Alright, so just make it. Then name the character in Greece and just anything, don't follow, because this is just mine. Alright, once you've done that, start making it. Okay, I'll see you. Alright guys, I'm back. This is my dude over here. Yes, he's kinda bad. I'm just using this project to make this tutorial for you, Then once you've done this, you need to like, make the moving stuff. And then after that you're gonna move it, like right, left, something like that. After that. Right, okay. So yeah, you're gonna make the moving costumes. Like this. Yeah, like this, like something like that. I'm gonna change the size to about 80 or about 60. 60 is fine when you use that size. So yeah, use 60. Then after that, we'll start coding him. And if I clicked, put in a forever loop. Then next costume. So yeah, it's going like crazy, so we're gonna fix that. So we're gonna add wait 0.07 seconds. That should do it. Yeah, works pretty well for it. Okay. So yeah, it can also let it say some things. Let's let it say you can let it say anything, just like, if you don't want to let it say anything, that's that, and then just unfollow this if you don't want it to say anything. So I'm gonna like let it say, blah 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 blah, I don't know what it's say anymore. So like, she's like blah 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 blah, and then you think that's it, because it's 2 seconds. So if we do it like 10 seconds, that's gonna take like a little long. See, it's still not done yet, so I recommend you to make it 3 or 2. If yours is long, you can make it, you can like make it about 5 or 7 seconds. So, after that, we make the attack box, and we don't even know what it is. So I'm gonna make it. Hey guys, I'm back, and I made my attack box already, as you see. So yeah, I already made my attack box. And now what you want to do is make the backhand. Right, so we're gonna okay, so your first one, just convert it to bitmap, and then paint it in color, all of it black, bingo. Did you see that? Okay, wait. Turn this to white. Make it that box like that. It's obvious. Then what you want to do is copy your attack box. Then make a new sprite called, let's call and call it out, and then call it outside. Okay, people. Then you paste the attack box, convert it to bitmap. And then do this. Do that, okay? Then you see it's like this, so you also need to put it at the same place like our attack box. Adjusting it, and yeah, then we start coding the attack box. Wait, don't forget to add this. I'm not sure if I told you this, but you also need to add this. Don't copy this, because it's like your boss fight should be in the place your boss fight is in right now, of course. So like put in a go to X and Y block under when flag is clicked forever loop. And then after that we're gonna start coding let's go to that box first. And flag clicked forever. Go to back layer. Change this to back, put it in the forever loop. Then for the outside, of course, and and then that clicked forever. Go to back layer. How long has this video been? 9 minutes, good enough. Okay, back layer. So yeah. See? Okay, that's it for my... So,